I get asked all the time how to create those product mockups that you see on sales pages, the ones that show like what's included in your online course. Well, in today's video, I'm gonna show you exactly how to create those product mockups. So stay tuned. Hey guys, my name's Amanda and I help creatives and coaches just like you get more leads and more sales for their online business. So if that sounds like something you wanna do more of, make sure you hit the subscribe button so that you can be notified every time I post a new video. Hey guys, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a product mockup for your digital assets. So something like a lead magnet, maybe a picture, a screenshot of your website, a product mockup of your online course, whatever it may be. This is a great way to show people what you are offering them, whether it's free or paid. So before we dive into this, I wanted to show you just a few examples. So here's one on one of my landing pages for the sales page roadmap. I include a mockup of the cover right here just to show people what it is that they're signing up for. It just gives them a little bit of a taste and hopefully entices them to sign up. So that's one example. And then another example is right here on my Instagram page is a mock-up of a Photoshop screen. So you could use this for anything. You could use this for like a screenshot of your website, a screenshot of a sales page if you're opening the doors to a new course. It could be anything. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you exactly how to create these types of product mock-ups, and we're gonna use a free tool called Canva. It is one of the best tools that you can use because it has a very small learning curve, and I'm gonna show you just how easy it actually is to create these mock-ups. The first thing we need to do is we need to create our image and choose what dimensions we want to do. So if you are sharing this mock-up on something like Instagram or Facebook, you can choose one of these designs that are already created for you that have dimensions already added. The other option that you can do is you can do a custom dimension if this is something that you're wanting to add to your website or a membership site and it has like a certain size that it needs to be. Go ahead and do the custom dimensions. To keep it easy today, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do this social media, which is 800 pixels by 800 pixels. So to create a product mockup, we're going to need a couple of things. We're going to need the actual mockup that has the laptop or the iPhone or the iPad. I'm actually going to show you all three today so that you can get an idea of just how easy it is to choose what type of device you want and add your screenshot into it. So we're going to first find our mockup photo. So there are a few places that you can find these mockup photos. A few of my favorites are Hotstock, Styled Stock Society, and Social Squares. So what we're going to do is once we have our images, we just need to go to uploads and then upload the image. The second thing that we need is we need our screenshot. So what is it that we want to actually display inside of the mockup? So what I'm gonna do to just take a screenshot of my landing page. So to do this on a Mac, you hold Command-Shift-4, then I'm going to upload that image into Canva. What we're gonna do is we're gonna add our product mockup right to our canvas here and size it however you would like it to fill the screen. You can offset it, whatever you wanna do. Now what we are going to do is we are going to add our screenshot to the canvas. So click and add that on there. And what I like to do, the easiest way that I found to do this is to actually just crop the photo into my screen. So I'm gonna hit this crop button right here while this is selected. And I am going to drag this, and you can see behind as I'm cropping this, you can see the outline of the actual laptop screen. So it makes it a lot easier to do. So I'm going to just drag this so that it is inside of the laptop screen as best as I possibly can. The straighter on that your screen or your device is, the better the mockup is going to work. So just keep that in mind when you're choosing one. So let's see how this looks. I'm gonna click done. Okay, that's not too bad. What I'm gonna do to just make it a little bit, you can rotate it a little bit if the rotation is off. What I'm gonna do is I'm actually just gonna make it a little bit smaller. And what that's going to do is it's going to bring out the black background, and I'm just kinda gonna use that as a frame. So you might just need to do a little more cropping here. I'm just gonna get it as good as I can. This isn't like the straightest image, so it's not gonna look perfect.
But like I said, we're just gonna do the best we can here. Okay, so that's not horrible. Let me just get that a little bit more. Not horrible. Not the best, but not horrible. The next thing that you'll wanna do is just download this. So what I like to do is download as a PNG. So hit download, PNG. You don't need to do a transparent background since there's already a background here, and then click download and you're ready to go. Okay, now I wanna show you how to create a product mockup using an iPad mockup. So once again, we're just going to choose our size. I'm going to do the social media one again. Then we want to upload both of those images again. So I'm going to upload my iPad image first. Then I am going to get a screenshot of my PDF that I want. And I'm going to use this one right here. So first what we're going to do is add our mockup to the page. Size it again however you would like. You could leave this one off a little bit more so that you could add text to the side over here, right here, or you could just make it as big as the screen, whatever look you are going for. Okay, next I'm going to grab my PDF cover. So I'm going to add this to my page. Now this one's a little bit trickier because we are angled a bit. So I'm gonna size this down a little bit to make it look more similar to the size that I'm working with here. And then we're gonna need to do some rotating to line it up to the actual iPad. So once you have it rotated correctly, I'm going to go up to crop. And we don't have to do too much on this one. It actually looks pretty good as it is because the camera was shot pretty straight on for the iPad. So there you go. I mean, look how simple that was and how easy that was. And now we have a mock-up of our lead magnet. Okay, next up, we're going to do the iPhone. So once again, I'm gonna do the social media. I'm going to go to uploads. I'm going to upload my iPhone graphic, grab a screenshot. Remember, Command-Shift-4 to choose the size. With iPhones, it's even better if you can actually just grab it right from your iPhone and then it's already sized the way that it should be. We don't have to do much cropping. So I'm going to go find my image really quick. Here is my image. So this is just a screenshot of my website. So what I'm going to do, again, I'm just going to size it down a little bit so that it matches up with the iPhone a little bit better, and then rotate it to the same angle as my iPhone. This one's gonna be a little bit trickier. It wasn't as straight on as the iPad one that we just did was, but that is okay because we're going to crop it. So get that, then we're gonna go to crop, get it as close as we can here. And there you go, that's pretty close. So,
and that's that. Let me know in the comments below if you gave this a shot and how it went. And if you like this video, click that like button, share it with your friends, and make sure you subscribe so that you get notified when I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Hey guys, my name is Amanda, and I help online creatives and coaches. No, I don't. Yes, I do, but I don't.